Expected two men and British Prime Minister Thatcher are expressing mutual concern over a possible superpower arm race in space.
Also, public school students in Chicago go back to class today after an unexpected 2 weeks vacation caused by a teacher's strike. And Second City Theater is marking its 25th anniversary as a training ground for many of the nation's comedians.
ABC News. This is World News This Morning for Monday, December 17, 1984. It's 6 a.m. Now from our Washington News Desk, Steve Bell and Andrew Matheson sitting in from Gaffney.
Good morning, everyone. As the U.S. prepares for next month's arms talks with Moscow, President Reagan will be getting a first-hand report on the Soviet view.
Britain's Prime Minister Thatcher and the Soviet Union's Mikhail Gorbachev agreed on a key issue. Both are opposed to the Reagan administration's controversial Star Wars defense concept.
Britain, ready to counteract another leak. Volunteer Farm endows the burlap curtains which had been hung around the Union Carbide complex, making them a barrier which would stop the heavy gas from escaping and neutralize its toxic effects. Planes and helicopters spray water into the air, the surest way to break down any of the gas into its harmless components. The state governor felt confident enough to tour the area.
No, I'm just going around so that we wouldn't be vulnerable in your soil.
Residents of the district's hardest hit by the gas leak 2 weeks ago didn't share the governor's confidence. More than 200,000 people have fled the city, leaving some areas deserted. Lone army patrols were the only sign of life on streets that are normally lined with people and animals. If all goes as planned, the last of the methyl isocyanate will be processed into pesticide by the end of the week. The danger of another leak will be over. But Bhopal will remain a city stricken and scarred for years to come. Jonathan Mann for NBC News, Bhopal.
On the militarization of space, saying that he opposes President Reagan's proposed Star Wars anti-missile system.
In other news, public school teachers in Chicago knows about the ups and downs of stardom. So while he's on top, he's trying to show underprivileged kids a way out. The U.S. Senator Kennedy reports to Hollywood.
In the fickle words of this year's superstar, beats all's has been. And Mr. T seems to understand that better than most. Although his A-team show is currently ranked in the top 10.
By the next day in Baltimore, I don't know what I'm going to do with the T-Cable on Earth, but it ain't going to do with TV. So I know only what I do for God will last. But if the day off the ball, nothing is true enough to last.
There appears to be little chance of that. As B.A. Baracus, Mr. T has become a genuine hero to the nation's young people.
I love it. When a plan comes together.
Mr. T prides himself on providing a good role model for his young fans, as he tells them, be somebody or be somebody's fool. If I can make it out of the ghetto, so can you. But some fellow blacks are upset with the tough guy in it, he objects. They question just how good a role model he's providing. Mr. T is fond of reminding people who grew up in Chicago's projects, where it's strictly survival of the fittest. Yet some fellow Christians have questioned how he could commit the violent acts described in his autobiography. Some people have a problem reconciling your past in which you say that you killed two people with your Christianity today. How do you respond?
How do you answer to God? And what avenue did you just come around?
Mr. T maintains it is precisely because he came from a tough background that he can steer ghetto kids on the right path. And to those who follow with his example, he replies, if you don't like it, don't watch. Sandy Kenyon, CNN, Hollywood. Around the world every half hour, this is CNN Headline News.
Today, Pope John Paul II gives his Christmas message to stress a key theme of his papacy, helping the millions of poor people around the world. The Pope said many rich people are in fact poor in spirit. He also had words of comfort for the victim train bomb. The Pope said the Church has sent a special message to Italian families mourning that tragedy. The train bomb has forced Italians to face the harsh possibility that terrorism in that country could increase. Italians have